This is a towel on my lap, so nothing drips on me.
Where's my towel?
Well, you're not going to need one. Hopefully you're outside of the splash zone.
Peel that off there. This is paraffin wax. This is what we're going to be using to heat up Mike's hand.
I'm excited about it. The bottom is really hot.
Okay.
So I'm going to avoid the bottom. Just stick my hand in, get it up to about the wrist without touching the bottom, and then I pull it out.
How's that feel? Harden a little bit. Try to keep your fingers spread a bit so it forms a glove.
How's it feel?
Warm. Warm and nice. This is something everyone should have at home. But I understand most people won't.
Harden before we put the plastic on. Now we want to trap that heat in.
Quite macabre looking. Isn't it?
It's weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
We're going to wrap that up because we want to hold in as much heat as we can. Give him the best stretch possible to loosen it all up and get the most function out of his hand.
I've had trouble with my wrists, and in fact in this particular wrist I've had a cortisone shot in between a couple of tendons in my wrist because I was feeling a lot of pain when I was doing something like this. Before the cortisone shot, I just yelped in pain and stopped. And then I flip it over and do the same thing, right?
Yeah.
We're still optimistic that it will eventually come back without some extreme measure. I think there's surgical possibilities if it doesn't, but that would be something I'd consider if months and months and months from now, things have not improved, you know?
This one,
it's about spreading the fingers so that I can get these babies, put them down. But I'm good at it, so I can stack them like a pro. Okay, there it is, in the plastic. But now,
lift your wrist up a little bit there. You can kind of see that underneath how it's peeling off.
Yeah.
It just comes off in one big wax glove. There we go. And his hand is super soft afterwards. Yeah, this is a stretch that you've been working on yourself on, like, every day.
I do every day.
But in therapy, I help just give you a real good stretch through this joint here. This is the really stiff area.
Okay.
How's that feeling?
Feels good.
Any pain through there?
No.
Good?
No pain in the thumb.
And we'll get you to do the stretch there, Mike. Maybe demonstrate how you... We'll do that yourself because we are transitioning to you doing your own programs. And we're going for getting the fingers flush with the back of the hand.
And it's better than it used to be. There's a bunch of things I couldn't do that I can do currently. But it's incremental. You know, it takes time. And generally Megan will be the one who'll point something out to me and go, you couldn't do that before. And you go, oh yeah, that's right, I couldn't. These things increase or decrease the tension. So once this thing starts hanging freely. You can alternate hands or use both hands at the same time. So we do that for a long time, gripping both these posts as tight as I can. It's an ingenious little machine, really, when you think about it. Somebody invented it. But as you can see, it's a pretty good little workout for your hands and wrists.
What's the device called?
Do you know what it's called, Mike?
No.
We call this the FEPS, which stands for flexion, extension, pronation, and supination. So flexion, extension, pronation, supination.
They used to just be like this. Mm-hmm. And that may not seem like much of an improvement, being able to get them up that far. But the goal, obviously, is to get them to be able to go straight up so that I'll be able to put my hands in my pockets, because that's where the money will be, with any luck at all.
So before your discharge, we're going to go through a full home program for you. So it's going to be similar to the things we've been doing here all along. I'll give you a complete list of ideas so that you don't run out of ideas, and also information on how you can upgrade your program or find new ways to challenge yourself. The other thing, though, is that you're going to be followed by outpatient occupational therapy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we do have that service available here.
My release date has been moved up from the 20th to the 18th. So I have to check out of here, just like a hotel, by 11 o'clock on the 18th. But it's good to know that at that point I'm not just, okay, good luck. You're out there on your own. We hope things go well for you.
Yes.
That's reassuring. Very, because I still have a long way to go.